With text blocks and switch expressions, Java 13 is simplifying how you work with multi-line string values and switch statements. In this video, you will see what are text blocks and switch expressions, why they are good for you, and how IntelliJ IDEA can help you use them. Let's get started. Imagine you have to store this HTML snippet as a string in your code. With Java 12 or earlier versions, one of the options was to code it manually using escape sequences and concatenation operator. As you can see, this is cumbersome to code. Another option was to copy-paste the HTML snippet in your code. Though it is simple to create, it still includes visual clutter in the form of concatenation operators and new line sequences. With Java 13, you can convert your multi-line strings to text blocks with ease. Just invoke context actions using Alt-Enter and choose the option Replace with text block. Without the visual clutter, the HTML value is simple to read and understand. Creating a text block from scratch is simple too. A text block uses three double quotes as its delimiters, unlike the traditional string values that use just one. You can either enter all the values manually or copy-paste them from a text file. Both these approaches work well. A quick rule to follow here. The opening delimiter can be followed by zero or more white spaces, but it must be followed by a line terminator. A text block value begins after this line terminator. IntelliJ IDEA can detect this missing line terminator and prompt you to correct it. You can use text blocks to store string values that span multiple lines. For example, to store JSON values or your database queries. For code that spans multiple lines or regular text that doesn't fit on a single line. Let's see what happens to the incidental white space in the text blocks. You would usually add spaces to your values to align them vertically in your code. What rules does the compiler follow to include or exclude these white spaces? In text blocks, the leftmost non-white space character on any of the lines or the leftmost closing delimiter defines where meaningful white space begins. IntelliJ IDEA helps you view this position using a vertical line, a feature that I absolutely love about text blocks support in IntelliJ IDEA. Here is how the vertical bar in IntelliJ IDEA lets you visualize the starting position of your text block value. By default, the trailing white spaces are removed in text block values. To add them forcefully, you can use this value. Or when you copy-paste the value with the trailing space, IntelliJ IDEA inserts it for you. Java isn't adding a variation of type string with text blocks. They are compiled to regular string instances, which is java.lang.string. To confirm, you can view the quick documentation using Ctrl-Q on Windows and Linux and Command-Q on Mac OS. This also means that you can call all string methods on it. You can format text blocks using multiple options. To align uneven text blocks, use Extend Selection by using Ctrl-W on Windows and Linux or Command-W on Mac OS to quickly select the text block contents. Invoke Context Actions using Alt-Enter. Select Adjust Code Style Settings, followed by Align with Multiline, and invoke Save. You can have a regular string which includes escaped double quotes. When you copy-paste text from such string to a text block, you get an option to remove the unnecessary escapes by invoking context actions using Alt-Enter. When you concatenate text blocks, variable or regular strings, the code is not so readable. In this case, you can invoke context actions and choose from multiple options. You can choose replace concatenation operator with string.format, or you can also choose Replace concatenation operator with java.text.messageformat.format to make your code more readable. You can replace concatenation of text blocks with a single text block. Invoke context actions using Alt Enter and choose Join concatenated string literals. Initially released with Java 12, switch expressions extend the switch statement, so it could also be used to return a value. This is an example of a switch statement. The control would fall through the switch labels without the break statements. Though often used as multi-way conditions to assign variables, switch statements did not return a value. Let's see how it has changed with the switch expressions. To convert a switch statement to an expression, invoke context actions using Alt Enter and select Replace with Switch Expression. There are multiple benefits here. The code is clear and concise. There is no default fall through between switch branches. It supports multiple case labels in a switch branch and can return a value. The code that follows the arrow in a switch branch could either be a value, an expression, a block, or a throw statement. The only difference in the switch expressions from Java 12 to Java 13 is how it returns a value. In Java 12, the break statement was used to return a value from a switch branch. However, it was dropped in favor of the yield statement because the developers found it to be confusing with the existing break statements. Unlike the cases of a switch statement, the cases of a switch expression must be exhaustive when you are using it to return a value, which means for all possible values that are passed to it, there must be a matching label so that a value could be returned. For types like in enum, which have exhaustive values, you can either define a matching label for all enum constants or define a default case. For types like int or string, you must define a default case. Text blocks have been released with Java 13 as a preview language feature. Switch expressions were introduced in Java 12 as a preview language feature and continue to be so in Java 13. At JetBrains, we support preview features from the latest Java version and upcoming releases if feasible. IntelliJ IDEA 2019.3 supports text blocks and switch expressions as preview language features for Java 13. 2019.3 no longer supports switch expressions as a preview language feature when configured to work with Java 12, because switch expressions have been modified in Java 13. Irrespective of the Java version you are using in your projects, you can use language or reference injection in IntelliJ IDEA to write and edit your multiline string values with ease. Editing a traditional string that stores a JSON value is not easy. In this case, you can use Alt Enter to show context actions, select Inject Language or Reference, and select JSON. Invoke Alt Enter again to edit your JSON fragment, which opens just the JSON value in another window. You can edit this value with ease. It also provides code inside of the injected language. In this JSON value, IntelliJ IDEA can detect a missing comma and suggest accordingly. IntelliJ IDEA sets a high bar for itself in terms of supporting new Java features. Java 13 is here, and the latest IntelliJ 2019.3 supports all the preview language features. Happy coding!